Welcome to UnityWeb 2.0 Training Part 2. This is a list of topics covered in this video. We'll begin with lab setup. To navigate to the lab page, point to Configure and click Lab. Each lab is assigned a primary lab number by BIORAD. Additional lab numbers for like instruments are available upon request. Type the lab number provided by BIORAD as well as the required information. Then click Add. Now that we've set up one lab, continue setting up other lab numbers if necessary. Next, let's take a look at the setup of lots. There are two ways to manually set up a lot, adding and duplicating. Adding should be used for totally new control products. Duplication is helpful when switching to a new lot number of an existing control. Duplication copies test settings and rule selections to the new lot. To add a lot, point to Configure and click Lot. Select the lab number that the lot will be added to. Select the control name. Note that non-BIORAD controls may be set up. Please refer to the user guide for details. Select the lot number. Then click Add. The lot is added. Now let's take a look at duplicating a lot. Select the lab number that the lot will be duplicated to. Select the lot number you want to duplicate. Click Duplicate. Select the new lot number. You have the ability to duplicate each item listed here. We recommend pausing the video to review this note on best practices. Click OK. The new lot number appears. When you are done using a lot, we recommend closing the old lot rather than deleting it. Select the lot. Then click Close. To reopen a lot, select the lot and click Open. Next, let's take a look at the setup of tests. There are multiple ways to set up new tests. Some customers add a single test manually. Others add multiple tests using the instrument setup feature. And some are required to add tests using their connectivity solution. We'll focus on the first two. Point to Configure and click Test. Select the lab and lot you want to add the test to. This is where you can select the test and its attributes. You'll also need to select an instrument and reagent. Note, Vitro's customers also need to specify the slide generation number for the dry slide instruments. Please refer to the user guide. Then select a method and unit. You may set up tests that are qualitative or semi-quantitative if the test exists in the database. Contact BIORAD if your test is not listed. Finally, select a temperature. Click Add. The new test appears in the open tests list. In some cases, instrument setup is the preferred method because it is faster. It allows you to add multiple tests at the same time. From the test page, click Instrument Setup. The Instrument Setup page appears. Select an instrument. If your instrument is not listed, please contact BIORAD, but you can use manual setup to proceed. Verify that the unit selection is correct. All tests for the instrument are selected by default. It is possible that two equally valid versions of the test appear. Clear the checkbox for the tests that you do not want to add. Click OK. The new tests appear in the open test list. Review each test to ensure that it is configured correctly. Please note that if you are a customer setting up a Vitro's instrument, in addition to clearing the checkbox for tests you don't run, enter the slide generation number. Let's return to the test page. Some customers may find it helpful to arrange tests in a particular order. Click the Sort button. Here you can move tests using the up or down buttons. Then click OK. Next, let's take a look at the setup of a user. UnityWeb 2.0 provides profiles with passwords and permissions to control user access to program functions. To set up a new user, point to Tools, point to Security, Then click Administrator. The Administrator page appears. Click New. Enter the user ID, username, password, and initials. Clicking this checkbox gives the user all of the permissions. These are the permissions. Refer to the user guide for more details. Click OK. Finish by assigning lab numbers to the user. This allows the user to view QC data in the software. Click the Assign Lab Numbers button. The Assign Lab Numbers page appears. Use the list to select the user you are setting up. Select one or more lab numbers to assign to the user. QC data is visible to the user based on these selections. Click OK. The user is now set up. Next, we recommend that you verify the settings in the Setup page. This allows you to take full advantage of the software's capabilities. Point to Tools and click Setup. The Setup page allows you to customize the software, including automated notifications. You can use UnityWeb 2.0 to evaluate your data by setting up rules. We recommend using WestGuard Advisor Online, an optional module, to automatically recommend the best rules for each test based upon specified quality requirements. Rules can be set up at the lot or test level. Best practice recommends setting up rules at the test level. However, the most efficient way to set up rules is by lot, where you set up general rules for the entire lot of tests. Then, identify tests with rules that are slightly different and edit the rules at the test level. Let's start with setting up rules at the lot level. Point to Configure, then click Rules Settings. Let's take a look at the various parts of this page. We'll move to the bottom to begin. Select a lab and lot number to set up rules for. The Rule buttons allow you to see a description of the rule. Click a Rule button to view an explanation. Some rules have two applications, within and across runs. Both will be applied in the software, but you can select them separately to see the explanation. In this section, you can choose the status for each rule. This includes reject, warn, or off. The default setting is off. Points that are rejected are not submitted to the peer group. Points that are flagged with a warning are submitted. Let's set up one rule to warn and one to reject. To apply the rules to all tests within this lot, or all labs for this lot, select the checkbox in the appropriate option. Then click Apply. A message about best practice appears. Select OK or Cancel. In this case, we'll click OK. Remember, you can edit individual tests within the lot as necessary. Let's return to the page where we left off. We'll move to the bottom to begin. Select a lab, lot, and test. Notice the rules that are already in use. Edit the rule selection for the test. Remove the check by Apply To. Click Apply. Now this test rules have been edited, but the rules for the other tests within the lot remain the same. Continue your training by viewing Part 3.